interesting shot coming up. Wish me luck. Get me out of here. I'm birding him out. See ya. Walk over here. We're at Wild Horse. Unfortunately, it's just gonna be me playing today. But I'm out here, I'm trying to shoot, hopefully below 80. But we're gonna record 9 holes, yeah, 9. Yeah. Beat my record, see what's the lowest I can shoot. I think the par here is par 32, right, on the front?
Yeah.
So, honestly, if I could shoot 32, that'd be great. First hole, haven't actually swung.
Par 34.
34, okay, good correction.
So par 34 on the front 9.
I'm not here by myself today, actually. I got my man.
Hello. Back again. Oh, still not golfing, but soon. Soon. I think tomorrow we're going to try to record another Saturday match. See how it goes. If I strain my wrist a little too much, I'm just going to stop playing, but we're going to give it a shot. It's been too long, man. I miss golf. I miss it.
All right, you've been here. You know the drill.
First hole, par 4, drivable. You can see the pin right there.
Fairway, okay. First swing?
Yeah.
I don't think.
Yeah, first swing, no warm up.
Come on, keep going. Good bounce. Really good bounce.
Yeah, you're in the middle.
It's gonna work. All right, pulling into my ball. 40 yards out, I'm almost pin high. Pretty good drive for no warm up. Don't have a lot of green to work with. Gonna open the face up a little bit and hopefully I can get a nice look at birdie. It'd be ideal.
Good. Come on. Oh. Oh, what a bad bounce.
What is that?
You got a putt.
I got a putt, but that was looking really good until it bounced straight right.
I don't know what that was.
That sucked.
This putt for birdie. Oh.
That's tough.
Par to start off the first hole. Damn, you hate seeing massive lips like that.
That's a lip and a half. Like, play that back. Whoop. Whoop. Golly, man. Second hole here. Par 3. It's playing 150. I think it's actually 145, but because it's uphill, it's playing about 150. I have a 9-iron. I really want to stick this one, you know, somewhat close. 10, 15 feet would be ideal. But I haven't swung an iron yet, so. Just good contact.
Wait, where did that land? I didn't even...
Fringe.
Okay. That's where I zoomed. I didn't see it.
All right, pulling up. Second shot. Just on the edge of the fringe. A little bit past the pin. Not a terrible miss. I get up and down for par. Actually, I might chip this. Okay. So, a little bit of technical difficulties. This is the second hole, as far as you guys know. It's pretty straightforward. Dogleg left, par 4. Gonna try and cut the corner a little bit. The hole sets up pretty nice when I'm hitting my draw the way I want to hit it. Hopefully have less than, like, honestly, a pitching wedge would be nice. So.
You threw the hill?
Flew the hill.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. I'm going to look at it on the positive note. I have a shot. I'm on some grass. Interesting shot coming up. I have a 5-iron. I got to keep it below this tree and not hit any of the trees in the front. So, wish me luck. Get through.
It should be right over this hill here.
Did I kick left?
I don't know.
I think
that would have been so good.
Dude, that was pure. Oh well. Unfortunate. Bounced off that tree, kick left, and I have more tree trouble. This time I only have one tree to worry about though. So I'm gonna try and play a low 7-iron and hopefully it rolls up. I really need to get up and down right here. It's pretty much a must.
Come on. Get up there.
Sit.
Oh my gosh.
I've rolled.
Yeah, I mean that was a good shot, but.
Fourth shot coming up. Kind of an awkward lie, downhill, short-sided, green's running away. Man, honestly, if I can get myself a tap in for bogey, I'm happy. Or at least an easy putt. That'd be ideal.
That's not going far enough. Oh.
Nice putt.
I started going left and I was like, oh my god.
Honestly,
I better fall.
Given the four shots that you had, like that's a hell of a double bogey.
I mean,
just with how they played out, the tree trouble and the.
And then I get to the green and I have a terrible lie.
Your downhill short-sided pin.
I definitely could have done better.
So, two over.
Two over. Are we doing through three?
It should be.
We played the second hole and.
We looked back at the footage.
We looked back at the footage and it basically cut out. Right when I went and hit my chip on the side of the green.
Yeah, and like, he hit a great chip, probably put 2 feet, and then tapped in for par.
Walked up, tapped it in.
Yeah, and we looked back to the footage, and it just cut out for no reason. So, technically, that would
This is the third hole, so I'm two over through three.
Yeah. So, two pars and a double bogey.
Fourth hole, I guess, is what we're going with.
Yeah.
It's par three, over the water, playing 156. This is right club. 9-iron. I'm going to throw a dart right here. Stop drawing. Ah, you mother effer. See, that's what I thought was going to happen on the first par three.
Yeah. That's pretty much Mac's problem right now is he doesn't know how big of a draw he's going to hit. He started that one at the right spot. It just got away from him.
Pulling up to my second shot. I'm actually like pin high, just a little bit to the left. Gotta get up and down. Wow. God damn.
All right, Mac has this to save par.
I think I just blocked it.
It's all right.
I take a deep breath, yeah. Golly, man, I have the biggest vagina. You know, it all started out with the fucking hole not recording.
Yeah, I know.
It's gone downhill since then. Okay, so as you guys can tell, my short game needs some work. It's in dire need of work. Putting is probably my worst part of my game. I feel like my driver's my weapon. Long irons are pretty freaking solid for, you know, how long I've been playing. Irons, sand wedges getting there. It's just my putting. And I feel confident in my chips, but the past couple have gone away from me. Yeah, four over through four, not out of it yet. So stay tuned. Honestly, if you're still here, you're the GOAT. Slap the subscribe button, hit the like.
We're gonna flip this around.
We're flipping it around.
Par five playing 543.
543.
Right down the middle. It's gettable in two if you absolutely hammer the drive.
That'll do. Davey, let's go.
Nice drive.
I don't think that was that big, but it's center fairway.
Center fairway. You can
That's
never complain with that.
That's what I needed. I'm hoping to have like a 7-iron in, and then I'm on in two for sure. All right, so. The viewers at home might not believe this.
We kind of don't even believe it.
We don't even believe it. We checked the calculator like four times. So the hole is 543 yards. And it's a center pin. And I have 175 left. So.
Sorry, focus.
If you do that math, it turns out to 368 yards.
368.
I have been hitting the gym lately.
I did the calculation like four times. And we looked at each other like, what? This is a par 5.
Par 5.
And it's 543 yards. We're playing it from the tips. 175 left into this is insane.
What do you think? I think I'm going to hit an 8. Last time I hit the same yardage yesterday, and I hit a 7 long.
Yeah, I think you want to be under the hole too on this one.
Yeah, agreed. Just block. Keep going. Keep going.
Oh, my shaky camera work.
That's a look. A chip in, possibly a putt. I'll take that. Honestly, that's not a bad miss. Right on the side of the green. Ignore that ball. He hit the same shot and threw a dart better than me.
Yeah, I'm kind of, I'm testing my hand a little bit here, seeing if I can get back into the action.
From what I've seen, he's ready. Honestly, I'm trying to make it.
This is for eagle, by the way. Get in. Oh, that was just a little too much. That's a good chip, though. Honestly, like, you got...
I wanted that one. Feet. I needed that one.
Four birdie. Great birdie.
Get me out of here. Birdie him out. See ya. 300 through 5.
300?
Right? 300 through 5.
Are you 300?
I mean, 3 over. Sorry. I wish I was 300. Man, boy, would you guys like this video if I was 300.
Pretty good hole there. So, yeah, 3 over through 5. Still, dude, can't even believe that drive he just had.
Yeah. Honestly, this little guy right here, piping it, 370, you got to leave a like for that. Come on.
Come on now.
Fifth hole, sixth hole.
Sixth hole.
Sixth hole. Par 3, playing 142. We always play the tips, always. So don't ever question that, all right? Unless we tell you otherwise.
Yes.
But for all Beat My Records and matches we play, it's going to be the tips. Short. I take everything I said back.
The really apex fat. Was huge.
It sounded fat, didn't it?
Yeah. Solid divot, though.
Dude, this ground is just so muddy. Okay, pin high, basically. Got a good look. Honestly, this is makeable, this chip. Babied it.
Yeah.
As Tom, I know you subscribed, as you would say, meow.
Nice putt.
I'm not even gonna lie, I'm mad nervous over these par putts. Like, I have to make a par.
3 over.
Honestly, my record's still in play, so 2 over. I get 2 birdies and shoot one over, I mean, and I would be happy with that. Seventh hole. I am currently 3 over. Dog leg right, par 4. Gonna hit a bomb. I'm telling you, if I hit this right, I should have, like, honestly, a sandwich. So, hopefully I can do that. Get a birdie, make it two over. There's the ball.
It's gonna be left fairway. Through the fairway?
I probably have like a P wedge out.
Tough.
So I was a little off. I'm right in between sand wedge and P wedge. I got my gap wedge. It's 118. I'm in the rough. Got a good lie though. So should play pretty true. Front flag. I think right at it. Hit straight. No draw.
Oh no.
Those downhill lies, bro. Gets me every time.
It's probably the worst shot you'll see of the day. All right, Mac, third shot. He doesn't have an angle, but he can get on the green, so he's trying to get on the green and have a putt. Oh, no. That's just such a tough spot, dude. Look how many trees. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And he had a 6th one in his backswing. That's really unfortunate just because he hit a bad second shot and put himself in that situation. That's pretty damn good. Wow, what a shot from there. That's the best you could have done.
Bro, there's so many rocks right there. Well, after the second and third shot, the fact that I'm about to bogey this hole, take it every time.
Facts.
This is for bogey. Great putt, dude.
I'll take bogey on that every time. I got really lucky on that four shot. It hit the hill pretty early, worked out. Sometimes that's golf.
Yeah, we'll take it. So back to four over through eight, right?
Through seven. This was seven, yeah?
Yes.
Four over through seven. All right, it's hole eight. It is a dead straight par four. I think it's pretty long. You hit a good drive, you probably got a seven iron, yeah?
Yeah.
Water on the right. I tend to favor the right side of on the miss on this hole for some reason. So I'm going to hit it straight down the middle. Finally hit a fairway on this hole.
Yeah, that was right down the pipe. Shot. Yeah, right. This is probably the best shot you've had on this hole.
Yeah, hit a good drive, thankfully. 127 out. I gotta hit a little knockdown P wedge. That's taking like 15 yards off my P wedge normally. So a three-quarter swing. Water on the right.
Yeah, that's the water he was talking about.
Hit a good drive just to chunk it. You hate to see it, honestly. That's how do you hit such a good drive and then you just can't hit a wedge right there? This is the struggles of me trying to figure out my golf game right here. I do that all the time. You have no idea. All right, second shot.
Third shot.
I wish it was my second shot. Third shot, 52 yards. Got to get up and down. Have to. Must.
Go in.
Go.
Oh my god.
I can't tell how close that is.
I think
walking up. I really couldn't have hit it better, to be honest.
Great par.
That's a par. See, that's the problem with my golf game. It's like really good, but also at the same time, terrible, just terrible. If I bomb a drive, knockdown P wedge, 127 yards, can't even hit the green. Like, just unacceptable. But that's the growing pains of golf, I guess. Yeah, honestly, if you're still here, you gotta leave a like for that chip. That was, 3 inches from the hole, 50 yards out, that's not bad. You're getting some decent shots out here. 368 yard drive, like, could be worse. This hole specifically is probably considered the hardest hole here. It's up for debate, but the scorecard says it is. It's a really tough par four. You got water right, that's very hittable off the tee box.
Right behind these trees.
And then your next shot is over water on the other side, the left side, that guards the green. So you really gotta hit a good drive, get yourself in a good position with a club you feel comfortable hitting. Because you gotta throw a dart on the second shot. Let's do it.
Let's get it, baby. I think it'll play out pretty nice, though. I don't know about that cam work, sorry.
Reaching too much, you know? It's really not the hole you want to hit the worst drive on, but I think I got away with it. So, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
He's four over through eight right now. If he birdies this one, even pars it. If he birdies it and he goes three over through nine, like, that's honestly not bad at all.
It's not bad. Considering how many shots I wasted,
yeah.
I feel like... All right, pulling up to my ball. I got away with it, honestly. Rolled off the hill, kind of came this way. So this is how the hole sets up. There's the water on the right, water on the left. That is actually an insane pin today. Holy cow. Man.
Yeah, he said there's water on the left, water on the right. There's also water behind the green. So with that pin placement, you can't go long. It'd probably be best just to hit center green, but.
Yeah, I'm gonna hit nine and play the center green.
Okay.
Oh.
Damn. Did that skip through? Did it skip through?
I'm the luckiest guy you've seen on this golf course today.
No way. So I didn't zoom in quick enough, but it right splashed. It splashed right behind that water fountain. He line drove it, and it hit the water.
Skips
out apparently, and he's on grass with a chip.
Woo!
What a break! All right, sorry for the noise. We're gonna try not to talk too much. This is where he skipped through. This is where he's at. He's got a chip for a birdie here. Again, apologize for the noise if the water is loud.
I'm gonna walk right into my shot,
I was gonna say, bro. This guy doesn't give a fuck. Just caught it a little too high.
Could be a lot worse.
Yeah.
Could be a lot better.
Four par. Meow. As Tom would say. Tapping bogey. Puts him five over.
If we're
going to
be honest, this hole, if you get a bogey, you're not upset. Like, it's just...
Oh, we say it every time, dude. If we bogey this hole, like, we're completely fine with that.
Par's ideal.
It's just such a hard hole. So, five over through nine.
Not my best performance.
Also, not the worst. Like, that's... Yeah. With a par 34, that's a 39.
I mean, we could go through and pick out five terrible shots that I hit, and if I hit better shots there, I shoot even.
Yeah. But think about that. You just shot a 39 on the front nine. If you duplicate that on the back nine, you're breaking 80.
That is true.
So, in my opinion, great round overall. Could have been better, but that record is hard to beat.
It's tough. Well, we're going to get there.
We're going to get there. This is just the video to start it off.
The interesting part is we have the same record, 38 and 38.
38 and 38, two over through nine.
So, at the same course, on the same nine.